Hey guys, and welcome back to SteamVR. Today I'm doing a short tutorial on how you can play budget cuts on any of the existing Windows mixed reality headsets, such as my Samsung Odyssey. Budget cuts is getting released later this week on Thursday on May 31, and unfortunately the game does not support Windows mixed reality headset officially, at least. So you will need to use some kind of button configuration or bindings to be able to play this game with any of the Windows mixed reality headsets. So in this tutorial I'm gonna show you how you do that step by step, and also what profile you can use that is already ready-made by me, so you can just jump into it and have fun on your Windows mixed reality headset. So guys, I hope you're gonna find this tutorial helpful, and don't forget to leave a like on this video and also subscribe to my channel if you would like to see more VR content such as gameplays, reviews and tutorials. So let's do it the manual way. I'm gonna show you how you bind your Windows Mixed Reality controllers with SteamVR and the budget cuts game, so they're all working, all the buttons and also the trackpad. So guys, first off, you're gonna need to have SteamVR running, and I really recommend you to use the beta version so you can have the motion reprojection active on or on auto mode, just because it's gonna help you a lot with the performance in this game. Once SteamVR is running, make sure the game is running as well in the background, and then sit in front of your computer. Go into your web browser and type in this address, 127.0.0.1, and here is a port number called 8998, and then /dashboard/controllerbinding.html. I'm gonna give you this link in my video description, and it's the same for all SteamVR setups and all computers. Once you're in here, you're gonna see some options here, and the first one is the current application, and that is budget cuts. That's only because we're running the game in the background right now. So let's click on it. Once you're in, the first thing you're gonna see is the current binding, and on your computer it's probably gonna look like this. It's gonna say default legacy binding for generic controllers. On my computer it says budget cuts WMR, but that's an old profile I created and tried to delete, but that was not even possible. Anyway, on your computer this little box is gonna be right up here on the current binding. I can show you an example. If I go back and go into the forest, I have not created any profile here, and here is how it looks on my computer. Current binding and default legacy bindings. Anyway, once you're in, click on the edit button on the default legacy bindings, and then now we're gonna see all the options for all the buttons on the left Windows Mixed Reality controller and also the right Windows Mixed Reality controller. So before we go into the buttons, let's go into the haptics. We're gonna enable the haptics by clicking on the left haptic, none. We're gonna choose the left hand output haptic. Do the same for the right and choose right, of course. Once that's done, click close. Now we're gonna map the buttons on the Windows Mixed Reality controller so they're working with the budget cuts game. And the buttons that we're gonna use, that we actually use in this game, are menu button, we have the grip button, we have the trackpad and the trigger. The joystick button is actually not used in this game, and not the system button either. So first off, let's go with the left Windows Mixed Reality controller. Click on the plus sign next to the menu, and now we get a new option, a new pop-up option that says button, complex button, toggle button or unused. We're gonna choose button. Now you see we have two options, click and touch. And the only thing we're gonna map here is the click, because we cannot even use any touch function on the menu button. So let's click on the none here. And now we're gonna map the menu button, click, to the left application menu, which is actually suggested. Once you've done that, do the same for the right Windows Mixed Reality controller, so the menu button is also working on the right controller. Choose button, and then choose click, none, and now you have to scroll down, because all these combinations are for the left controller, but down here we see all the right controller buttons and options. So choose the right application menu button, which is suggested here, and now we're done. So let's click on this little sign just to save that here as well, and now let's go into the grip button. The grip button is the same procedure, just click on the plus sign, click button, and also we have two options, click and touch. We're only going to use click. Click on the none and choose left grip button, which is also just suggested over here. Once that's done, go into the right Windows Mixed Reality control and do the same for the grip button. Choose the plus sign, choose button, and then under the click one, click on the none, and now you have to scroll down so you find the right grip button, which is here, right grip button suggested. There we go. Now click on those little OK signs or wherever they are called, so we save our progress. The joystick button is not used in this game, so we can just skip that for this tutorial. Also, the system button is not necessary. Let's move on to the trackpad now. Click on the plus sign on the left controller, of course, first of all. And this time we're not gonna use the button. This time we're gonna use the trackpad. So now when we do that, we have three options. We have click and we have touch. Choose the none on the click first. And we're gonna find the left trackpad click, which is left trackpad thumbstick press in this case. Also, for the touch, we're gonna choose none again and then left trackpad thumbstick touch. I'm not sure if we really need to use this touch because there is no touch function on the trackpad for this game at least, but well, let's just do it like that. The position is not needed, so just leave it as it is. Save the progress and do the same for the right controller. Choose trackpad. Remember to choose trackpad and not the button this time. Trackpad, so you get all the three options. Then do click. And now you have to scroll down to the right trackpad thumbstick press. And then do the same for the touch. Scroll down to the right trackpad thumbstick touch. Once that's done, save your progress. The last button that we're gonna map is the trigger button, of course. Let's click on the plus sign once again on the left controller trigger and choose now trigger. It's very important that you choose trigger. Now we have three options. One is click, one is touch, and the third one is pull, which I really don't know if you really need. First off, let's go click. Click on the none, and now let's choose the left trigger press, which is here. Do the same for the touch and choose left trigger touch. Well, I have not assigned the pull, but you can actually do that by clicking on the left trigger value, but I'm not really sure if that's really necessary. Anyway, here is our combination now. Let's save it and do the same for the right trigger button. Let's choose trigger and not button, and then use click, and then scroll down to the right trigger press. Do the same for the touch. Scroll down and choose right trigger touch, and then on the pull, let's do the right grip value or trigger value, I'm sorry. So there we go, save your progress. And now what you need to do now is to save this as a personal binding. You can also publish it to Workshop just like I did. That's why you're gonna see my profile in your SteamVR. I'm gonna show you that in a second. First off, save your personal binding and well, call it wherever you want. For me, it's, I'm gonna call it Budget Cuts Windows Mixed Reality Mappings. Let's save it. And now the profile is saved. And once I click on the Publish to Workshop, this profile is actually gonna be public for everyone to choose to use their mixed reality controllers with the Budget Cuts. And I'm gonna do that upon publishing this video. So right now, while you're watching this video, my profile is already available for you to just click and use. So you don't actually need to go through all these procedures. If you would like to use my profile instead of doing it manually with the binding I just showed you, just go into the game and go into SteamVR dashboard. While you are in game, go down to settings down here, choose controller binding. You're gonna see the current application being the Budget Cuts. Click on it. Once you're in, you're gonna see down here in community, you're gonna see my Budget Cuts Windows Mixed Reality created by SteamVR. For me, it says personal, but I'm gonna show you an example. If I go into the forest once again, I'm gonna show you that community bindings, it shows me two other bindings that some other users made. And this is how it's gonna look for you. It's gonna say, SteamVR made the profile for the budget cuts. So what you just do is go inside, check view, and then select this binding. Once you've done that, just go back into the game and your controllers should magically start to work. So you can actually start off a game and have fun in virtual reality with your Windows Mixed Reality headset in budget cuts. So while in game, it's very easy to use the Windows Mixed Reality controllers in budget cuts. The menu button, which switches between the translocator, the grip handle, and the magnifying glass, is easy to reach. The teleportation works great with the trigger button and the grip button, and also the inventory, which is accessible with the press of the trackpad button, works just as on the Vive controllers. Of course, you cannot expect the same level of precision using the Windows Mixed Reality headset because it's inside-out tracking. And inside-out tracking will never have the same precision as the lighthouse tracking, especially while using the phone, for example. It's very easy to press the wrong buttons, but you probably get used to it very, very fast. Also, moving the controllers high up above your head while trying to teleport, for example, which is actually outside of the view of the inside-out cameras, could cause some tracking loss, which means that your translocator or your hands get stuck in the air for a short moment. And well, this is maybe not a big issue, and probably you are already used to this if you are playing on the Windows Mixed Reality headsets daily, because this is quite a common issue with inside-out tracking. Having all that said, playing budget cuts on the Windows Mixed Reality headset, such as the Samsung Odyssey, is a blast. The game is already very sharp, especially if you add some super sampling, for example 1.6, as I did in my last video playing on the HTC Vive. But I can promise you, playing it on the Samsung Odyssey with the same super sampling of 1.6 that I used in my last video, it looks way sharper. So how about the performance? Well, as I already mentioned in my last video, the performance of the budget cuts, at least the pre-release version that I've just been playing, is not really optimized yet. And there is a lot of reprojection used, especially in certain areas and, well, bigger areas, and also especially when fighting those robots. But playing on the Windows Mixed Reality headsets is almost a completely butter smooth experience, mainly thanks to the Windows Mixed Reality motion reprojection support, which is added in the SteamVR Beta since a while ago. The motion reprojection feature is equal to the Oculus Rift Asynchronous Space Warping (ASW), and it does a great job making the image perfectly smooth despite frame drops here and there. Personally, I cannot understand why Neatcorp decided not to add Windows Mixed Reality controller support into budget cuts, but thankfully we can still play this game natively on the Windows Mixed Reality headsets just by adding the controller bindings. Having that said, I really hope that Neatcorp changes their mind and adds Windows Mixed Reality support upon launch of budget cuts this Thursday. But if they don't, just use the steps in this tutorial or simply use my controller profile as shown earlier, and I hope you will enjoy budget cuts on your Windows Mixed Reality headsets such as the Samsung Odyssey. Guys, I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and I hope you're gonna enjoy budget cuts on your Windows Mixed Reality headset. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and thank you so much to my Patreons as well. If you would like to support me on Patreon, please join today. Guys, have a lovely day and see you in my next video. Cheers.